very moment that you landed in Monrovia, you could tell everybody has Ebola on their minds at all times. It's easy to say, okay, there are 22,000 cases, there are 8,500 deaths in a year, but that doesn't even begin to touch upon how devastating this disease is.
This epidemic is taking many people's lives. In morning rounds, I would see a patient breathing really fast and just visibly sick, knowing that they may not be there tomorrow. That's really hard.
A lot of the Liberians that I worked with just seemed sort of exhausted. I worked on developing the contact tracing standard operating procedures. The contact tracers' jobs were to go out every single day and visit every known contact of a case and monitor their symptoms, and as soon as they become symptomatic, to isolate them and take them to care. We know how Ebola spreads, it's not a surprise. So if we monitor everyone that has been in contact with someone who is a case, we'll be able to stop this, essentially.
But the reality on the ground is that there are huge gaps, and infection control practices are one of them. There's a clear need. This is a way that we can actually help take care of health providers, community members, and stop the spread of Ebola.
What I was asked to do was to conduct trainings in very rural areas to help the frontline health workers prepare for any potential Ebola victims. And we spent many hours in many days putting on the protective gear, taking it off, practicing it, creating this muscle memory so that you wouldn't make any mistakes when you're actually treating patients. The only comfort that I can give to a patient is a hug or a handshake. But even that, I wasn't allowed to do in Liberia. I can't really imagine what it's like to be a Liberian doctor or a Liberian nurse, where that is now the norm.
To really see the healthcare providers grow confidence in themselves in how to identify patients who may have Ebola and therefore may put their healthcare facility themselves and the other patients there as a risk. Those little day-to-day changes in their healthcare facility were probably some of the biggest accomplishments.
The response to Ebola is clearly going to be a many years long process, maybe even a decades long process.
I decided to go because I felt that I had the skills necessary to help with this response, and also because I think that every life is just as valuable.